We'll look at concurrency in Scratch. That's when two scripts execute at the same time. Tricky things can happen. Here I have scripts that start when the green flag is clicked. Let's listen to each one of them individually. So the one on the left sounds like this. The one on the right sounds like this. If I click the green flag, I hear them both at the same time. Could you hear that? So with a half block, I can start two scripts playing at exactly the same time. I'm going to work with the variable age. And let's look at two set blocks in a row. This one says set age to 6, and then it says set age to 20. What do you think age will be after I double click this? See if you're right. Yep, age is 20 after that. If I put them in the other order, if first I set age to 20 and then I set age to 6, then it will set age to 6 in the end. See? Okay, now what happens if I have scripts like this, where when I click the green flag, this one sets age to 20 and this one sets age to 6? Pretty tricky. Which do you think it'll be? Do you think it'll be 20 or 6? If we put a wait block in here, then both scripts would start running at the same time. This one would set the age to 6, and this one would wait 1 second. And after it waited 1 second, it would set the age to 20. Remember that the last set block is the one that determines the final value of the variable. So here, the last set block to get executed would be set age to 20. So if we remove the wait, in computer science, this is called a race condition. This is where they're going to race to see which one gets to set the value of age. I'll change this to 10. And now we'll see if it sets it to 20 or 10. Here it set it to 10, but it would have been just as correct if it had set it to 20. Pretty tricky, huh? In computer science, we have to be careful when we have situations like this that are called race conditions.